Hello, I'm Robin Whalley, welcome to Lenscraft. Today, I'm looking at some of the many ways you can use to resize your images in Affinity Photo. When I first started looking at this, I had some real surprises, so be sure to watch the entire video. There's also a full tutorial to accompany the video on my website. I'll include the link in the YouTube video description. We'll start by looking at something called the canvas. Every image you edit in Affinity sits on something called the canvas. You don't normally see the canvas because it's the same size as the image, which then covers it. It also doesn't show up in the Layers Studio panel. If you want to see the canvas, you need to make it bigger than the image. When I click the Document menu, I can pick the Resize Canvas option. Then I can enter the new size in pixels, or I can use another unit of measurement by changing the units dropdown. The anchor is also important because it sets the location for the image once the canvas is resized. If I pick the center anchor, the canvas will extend out from each edge of the image. Now you can see the canvas, which has a checkered pattern to show that it's currently transparent. If I export this image as a PNG file, the canvas will retain its transparency. But if I save it in a format that doesn't support transparency, like JPEG, the transparent area turns white. This produces a larger image, but the actual photo is still the same. You can also turn off the transparency in the Document menu if you want to. Now you know what the canvas is, let's look at resizing the actual image. Possibly the most common way to do this is to use the Resize Document option in the Document menu. This opens the Resize dialog, where we can control different aspects of the resizing. At the top of the dialog, I can enter a new width and height for the image. The closed padlock icon in the center locks the aspect ratio of the image when we're resizing. If I type in a new width and press enter, you'll see the height field updates automatically in proportion. This keeps the aspect ratio of the image the same. You can toggle the aspect ratio lock off and on by clicking the padlock icon. Below this, we have different measurement units which you can pick from a drop-down list. And below this, you have the DPI and resampling settings. The DPI controls the number of pixels in each inch of the image. If I change the units to be inches, you'll see that the 12,000 pixel width becomes 50 inches at 240 DPI. Affinity Photo even includes a description in the dialog to show this to you. Let's change the units back to pixels. Watch what happens to the number of pixels when I remove the resample option. It changes back to the original image size because resampling is how Affinity adds or removes pixels in an image. If it can't add new pixels, the pixel count of the image has to stay the same. Let's change the units back to inches, and you'll notice I can now enter a new image size. Watch what happens to the DPI number if I set the width of the image to be 50 inches. It reduces to 126. Because Affinity can't resample the image to create new pixels, it has to spread the existing pixels over the new image size. In other words, we have fewer pixels per inch in the image. I'll reset the resampling options and the DPI back to 240. When the resampling option's on, I can pick one of the resampling methods. These control how Affinity creates or removes pixels in the image, and different methods have different strengths. Nearest neighbor is better for things like diagrams and line art rather than photos. Bilinear is good for reducing the size of images, and bicubic for increasing them. The two Lenscraft methods give better results than the others, but for photos, they take a little longer to process. Let's resize the image and look at the results. The process is surprisingly fast, and when I magnified the image to 100%, the results look very good. I'll go back to the original image now, and I'll show you another way to resize it. This time, I'll use the Resize Pixel Art option in the Document menu. The resizing options in this dialog are quite limited, and I can only increase the size of the image. I'll use the 2x option to double the size of the image, which should be just a little bit larger than the last example. I can then pick the method, which is either HQX or XBR. Now, I can't find much out about these, other than XBR is supposed to give a slightly smoother enlargement. I'll be using the HQX option for this enlargement. The first surprise is just how fast the resizing is. It feels almost instant. The other surprise is actually the quality. It's not quite as sharp as the Lanczos method of resampling, but it's not far away and it's very usable. Having covered all of this, we can now look at a couple more options for image resizing. The first is in the export dialog, when we can create a JPEG or TIFF file from the image. In the dialog, we can change the size of the image that's created and pick the resampling method to use. The benefit of resizing when exporting is that you can keep the image you're working on at its original size. Working on the original image size is often easier when editing, and it's faster. It also means you can produce a master image and then use this to generate the other image sizes when you need them. Now for the final method, which you'll find in the export persona. Like the previous approach, you only create the resized image when you export it. The benefit of using the export persona is that you can batch up multiple exports for the same image. To do this, we use the Slices Studio panel. It's called Slices because you can use it to slice up the image and export just small areas. For this example, I'll use the default slice, which is the entire image. I can then pick the file types that I want to create, so I'll pick a TIFF file and a JPEG. For the TIFF file, I'll output the image at its original size. But for the JPEG, I'll create two enlargements of the image, one at 2x and one at 3x the original image size. One of the limitations of this method, though, is that you can only use the predefined size options. But you can pick the resampling method for each using the Export Options Studio panel. Once you've set up the options, you can export the image individually or export all of them at once. Now, all the methods we've looked at have their strengths and weaknesses, but all of them can probably have a useful place somewhere in your editing. I hope you've picked up some tips for the video. If you have any others to share, please add them in the comments below. I'm Robin Whalley, you've been watching Lenscraft. I'll see you next week for another video.